You're watching Bully Badass TV, YouTube's best channel for dog lovers.
The American Staffordshire Terrier, also known as an Amstaff, is a medium-sized, short-coated American dog breed. Despite its name, the Staffordshire Terrier originates in Birmingham, West Midlands, rather than in the English county of Staffordshire, where it was later bred. Some historians contend it was the White English Terrier, Fox Terrier, or Black and Tan Terrier that were crossed with the Bulldog of the day to develop the Staffordshire Terrier. This new breed, created by breeding Old English Terriers and Old English Bulldogs together, produced a dog that combined the gameness of the Terrier and the strength and athleticism of the Bulldog. The cross of Bulldog and Terrier was called by several names, including Bull and Terrier Dog, Pit Bull, or Half and Half. Later, it assumed the name of Staffordshire Bull Terrier in England. These dogs, bred in England, eventually arrived in the United States, where they became the direct ancestors of two developing breeds. The American Staffordshire Terrier and the American Pit Bull Terrier were bred from the same lineage, but were bred in two different directions and received different names from the two American Kennel Clubs. Staffordshire was a name given by the American Kennel Club, and American Pit Bull Terrier was given by the United Kennel Club. After dog fighting was banned in the United States in 1900, the two strains of these dogs were developed as a show strain and as a non-show strain. The show dog was the American Staffordshire, while the working dog was the American Pit Bull Terrier. The American Staffordshire Terrier should give the impression of great strength for its size, a well-put-together dog, muscular but agile and graceful, keenly alive to his surroundings. He should be stocky, not long-legged or racy in outline. Height and weight should be in proportion. A height of about 18 to 19 inches at the shoulders for the male and 17 to 18 inches at the shoulders for the female. The life expectancy for the breed is generally 12 years with good care, but could extend longer with good fortune. The American Staffordshire is an intelligent, happy, outgoing, stable, and confident dog. Gentle and loving toward people, it is a good-natured, amusing, extremely loyal, and affectionate family pet. It is good with children and adults. Almost always obedient, this dog wants nothing more than to please its master. Over the years, careful breeding has produced this friendly, trustworthy dog that is especially good with children. Some unsocialized Amstaff may be dog aggressive. Amstaff should be socialized very thoroughly when they're young to curb any dog aggressive tendencies. When properly trained and socialized, a staff makes a great family companion. This breed is not for the passive owner who does not understand that all dogs have the instinct to have a pack order. They need a firm, confident, consistent owner who understands how to display proper leadership. The objective in training this dog is to achieve the position of pack leader. It is a natural instinct for the dog to have an order in its pack. It is the human's responsibility to set the pack's agenda and hierarchy. You and all other human beings must be higher up in the order than the dog. That is the only way your relationship can be a success. Staffordshire Terriers will do okay in an apartment if they are sufficiently exercised. They are very active indoors and will do all right without a yard. The breed prefers warm climates. Daily exercise is paramount. Without it, an American Staffordshire Terrier will become hard to handle. They need to be taken on long, brisk walks or runs. While out on the walk, the dog must be made to heel beside or behind the person holding the lead. As instinct tells a dog, the leader leads the way and that the leader needs to be the human. Teach them to enter and exit doorways and gateways after the humans. All dogs have the potential to develop genetic health problems, just as all people have the potential to inherit a particular disease. Run, don't walk from any breeder who does not offer a health guarantee on puppies, who tells you that the breed is 100% healthy and has no known health problems. Amstaffs are a relatively healthy breed, although occasions of heart murmurs, thyroid problems, skin allergies, tumors, hip dysplasia, hereditary cataracts, and congenital heart disease are known to affect the breed. The most serious ailment potential owners should be on the lookout for is ataxia, which is a very serious health problem in the breed. There's a genetic test for ataxia, but can only be done once a dog reaches the age of 3 years old. If you're looking for an Amstaff, it is wise to ask any breeder if their puppies are guaranteed free of ataxia or not. It is a recessive trait, so if one parent is tested ataxia clear, then they can safely know that the puppies will not be affected by the disease. Amstaffs are not a breed for beginners. A new owner should have some dog experience, but most importantly, be prepared to be an active and involved pack leader.